In this video, we'll talk about the force exerted by the jet onto an unsymmetrical curved moving plate. I have split this topic into two videos, and this is the first part of that video. So in this, I will introduce these two triangles to you. Okay, and in the next video on the same topic, I will discuss about the calculations based on these two triangles. Okay, now one thing, that this is the curved blade moving in a horizontal direction, but the jet of water is being throwing a jet in a tangential direction. So this is how the jet enters at the tip of the blade or the plate and moves over this curved plate and goes out in a tangential direction as well. Now V1, VR1, VF1, VW1, U1, these are some terms which are linked to this triangle ABD, okay, or the entire ABDC, this entire triangle. And then you have VR2, V2, VF2, U2, VW2, which are linked to the upper triangle. This triangle is called the inlet velocity triangle. Inlet velocity triangle. And the upper triangle is called the outlet velocity triangle. Okay. Now let's understand and remember these terms. Now the water or the jet of water is coming at a velocity of V1 towards the plate. So V1 becomes the absolute velocity of jet of water. Now this plate is moving with the velocity of U. So the jet and the plate, they both have a velocity in the same direction. Okay, or they have the same sense of the movement. So the jet will not hit or will not strike the plate with this absolute velocity. There is a relative motion in between the two. So it will be hitting it with a different velocity, which is VR1. That is the velocity of the jet with respect to the plate, because they are both moving. So it hits or it strikes the plate with a velocity VR1, which is the relative velocity in between the plate and the jet at the inlet. Okay, then you have U1. Now U1 is the blade velocity at the inlet tip, and U2 comparatively would be the blade velocity at the outlet. Okay, so we'll discuss about these two velocities in a while. So we have discussed about the absolute velocity and the relative velocity VR1. Now comparative, you will have V2 on the outlet velocity triangles and VR2 on the outlet velocity triangle as well. So let's abbreviate this as OVT and this as IVT. Okay, now if you look at this, the jet strikes at VR1 in actual at the inlet tip, and the water will come out in the absolute terms from the outlet tip with a velocity V2, but in actual it will come out at a velocity VR2. Okay, now there are two components, VW1 and VF1. These two components are of this absolute velocity V1. So VF1 is called the flow velocity, and VW1 is the whirl velocity. Okay, then you have two angles, alpha and theta, in the IVT. Alpha is called the guide blade angle. It is called the guide blade angle. And if you talk about the geometry, this is the angle between the absolute velocity of the jet and the direction of motion of the plate. So if this is the jet velocity, we know that the motion of the plate is in this direction, so this would be alpha. Okay, similarly you have theta. Theta is the angle in between the velocity vector VR1 and the direction of motion of the plate. So this is V1, and similarly you will have VR1, and this angle will become theta. Okay, So this is the angle between VR1 and direction of motion of blade or plate. Okay, this is also called blade. Right, so this is for the IVT. Similarly, you will have everything for OVT, that is the outlet velocity triangle. So in place of alpha, you will have, because alpha is in between the absolute velocity and the velocity of the plate. So okay, so absolute velocity is V2. Okay, so V2 and this velocity, which is the line GH, so you will have value beta. So corresponding to alpha on the OVT, you have beta, and corresponding to theta, that is the angle between the VR value and the velocity of the plate, it is theta. So if you go back to the OVT, it will be phi, VR2 and U2. So you will have phi on the outlet velocity triangles, and similarly you will have VW1 and VF1, which are the two components of the absolute velocity V2. Okay, so you will have VW2 on the OVT and VF2 on the OVT, as you have VW1 and VF1 on the IVT. Okay, so this triangle, remember it by heart, is called the IVT or the inlet velocity triangle, and this is the outlet velocity triangle or OVT. So I hope you have understood and you will remember these terms that will be used while solving the questions. Now let's move on to the second part of the same topic and look at some calculations based on these two triangles.